VA cares for about 1 million veteran patients every year on the cancer care continuum, from screening to survivorship. Nearly 55,000 new cancer diagnoses occur each year in VA, and new and more common forms of cancers are continuing to rise, some of which are connected to military service. VA's National Oncology Program strives to identify and deploy a wide variety of cutting-edge technology and data, empowering our care teams to innovate how we manage cancer for veterans.
So my name is Dr. Leah Zulig. I'm a health services researcher and implementation scientist at the VA. The VA is doing a lot of really exciting things in oncology care. There are a couple of areas that I'm particularly proud of. Courage is the Center for Oncology Outcomes Review and Gender Equity. The goal of Courage is really to engage veterans who are diagnosed with breast and gynecologic cancers in cancer care. The VA is a learning healthcare system. So when I, as a researcher, can identify a gap in care, whether that's an area where we have potential improvements that we can make in terms of timeliness of care or getting cutting-edge care to veterans, we can actually partner with our clinicians and our operational partners to make a change in how we're delivering care in real time. And we can also do that with experiences of care. And we have an opportunity when we find something that works well to scale it up across the entire healthcare system so that all veterans can receive that care.
My name is Deepak Bora, a cardiologist at the Durham VA. I'm also the VA's executive director for the National Pharmacogenomics Program. The National Pharmacogenomics Program, our main goal is using genetic test results to help better understand how our bodies process and respond to different medicines. And what we're trying to do is make pharmacogenomic testing or genetic testing for medicines available across the entire VA healthcare system. We've learned that some people need different doses of medicines because they break down the medicines faster or slower. And if we know that information, we can better optimize that prescription, help prevent side effects, and if we can manage those symptoms, maybe they can tolerate their therapies better, and because of that, they can get their cancer treated more effectively.
Oncologists can take care of the person's cancer, primary care teams can take care of their comorbid conditions, they can partner with mental health care providers. It's really a robust team-based approach, and that's a real value of the VA. What we hear from veterans often in talking with them is that they like getting care in the VA because the VA understands the experiences that have led them to this point. That the VA actually does really provide cutting-edge cancer therapy. When we look at the quality of care that's provided in the VA and in, for example, fee-for-service Medicare, VA consistently performs better. Our outcomes are better, our patients live longer, and our patients are happier with the care that they receive. And then we can meet their needs not only related to their cancer care, but also everything else about them as a person. So it's really taking care of the whole person, and I think that's a huge advantage that the VA has.
Every one of those numbers is a patient, is a spouse, is a caregiver, is a son or a daughter, a family that's impacted. If we can reduce any of those, I just think about the magnitude of impact and quality of life that can be improved. That's why I choose to practice medicine in the VA and why I think veterans should choose the VA for their healthcare.